Probably the biggest myth is that money's the answer. Well, actually, it might be the answer if you don't have life's necessities. If you're hungry or scared that your children won't have food or clothing, it's hard to experience joy. International studies found the least happy people live in the poorest countries. Money would help them. University of Illinois psychologist Ed Diener.
When we ask people in China and India and places like that to fill out a scale how happy you are, we get a pretty high percent of people who say, I've never thought about that before. In America, you get virtually nobody who says that.
Americans have time to think about it, and we seem to have become increasingly convinced that maybe money will buy happiness. 25 years ago, when college students were asked, what's important? Most said family, or developing a meaningful life philosophy. But today, most students say, being very well off financially.
You've just won $10 million.
Well, if that's true, then people who win a lot of money should be happy. But are they? Meet some lottery winners. Teresa Brunning of Colorado won $1 million. Janetta Williams won $5 million in the Arizona lottery. Curtis Sharp collected $5 million in New York.
For a time, it seemed like I was in a dream world, you know?
Did you come down to Earth?
Oh, yes. I came down, you know. I came down to Earth. I got divorced from my first wife and married my second wife, and I spent a lot of money on the wedding, you know.
$100,000 on a
grand
wedding.
That didn't last 5 years, you know what I'm saying?
Maybe he didn't win enough. Sherry Gagliardi and her husband won $26 million.
I was numb for 3 years.
But you must have been happy.
Yes and no. I got a divorce in 2 years after we had won.
Studies of lottery winners have found that within a year, most say they are no happier than they were before they won.
Money didn't buy you happiness?
No, of course not. You could buy a therapist, you know, marriage counselor. People have a misconception about having money. You go out and you go, oh, that's what I want, I'll buy it. A couple weeks later, it's like, yeah, that emptiness comes back. Then what?
I mean, how many suits can I wear? How many hats can I wear? You know what I'm saying?
Oh, come on. I noticed that none of these winners is offering to give the money back. It's nice to be able to buy things.
Good afternoon. Would you like to try Eternity for Ladies?
Life, liberty, and the purchase of happiness has become the new American dream.
Psychologist David Myers, who spent 6 years examining hundreds of studies on happiness for this book, says once you get past poverty, money doesn't help, no matter how much stuff you buy.
The stockpiles of CDs, the closets full of clothes, the big screen stereo TV systems.
Doesn't do it.
Clearly it doesn't do it. People having achieved that level of wealth have now adapted to it, and it takes new increments, a faster computer, a bigger TV screen or whatever, to rejuice the joy that the initial purchase gained for them.
To rejuice the joy. You see it in babies. Give a three-month-old a mobile with two objects and most like it. But researcher Jeffrey Fagan of St. John's University says if kids are given a 10-object mobile and then you try to get them to go back to the two-object one, they lose interest or cry.
We get used to having more and it doesn't work anymore.
That's right. And that's why today with double the incomes and double what money buys for us, we're no happier than we were 40 years ago.
Still, in a culture that celebrates affluence, aren't the richest people happier? Probably not. A survey of 49 of the Forbes richest found little difference.
In fact, 37% reported happiness levels less than average. We attain a new level of success, and then we compare ourselves to those who are a rung or two higher on the ladder and feel relatively miserable.
Guests included Prince Alfonso of Marbella, the Duchess of Sevilla.
I mean, just look at the lifestyles of the rich and famous. Don't they look happy? Wouldn't you like to be like them?
Yeah, I am. I'm on TV.
So are you very happy?
No.
It seems that no matter how much we have, many of us are just convinced there is more happiness over there.